Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well. In this video I will show you how to do the Northern Light glazing technique. For those who don't know me, I'm Colin from Colin Ceramics. I'm 17 years old and I've been making pottery for about 3 years. I live in the Netherlands, so I'm not very good at speaking English as you can hear, but I hope you understand what I'm saying. If you like, you can follow me on Instagram and TikTok. I post timeless videos of the process of making pottery, and on my Instagram I also post pictures of finished results, so if you're interested, please check it out at Colin Ceramics on Instagram as well as TikTok. In this video I will be glazing 3 different mugs with 3 different glazing combinations. For the first one I use obsidian, seaweed and smoky Merlot. For the second one I use obsidian, smoky Merlot and indigo float. And for the last one I use obsidian, smoky Merlot, seaweed and indigo float. So for these 3 glazing variations you need 4 different glazes, but you could also try to do the same with other glazes, or you could experiment with other variations within these 4 glazes. So let's get started. So we start with So when you're finished with the obsidian, you can now start adding the colors. So the first one which I will be showing you is with the seaweed and smoke mallow. I will now show you a picture how it will look after the firing, so you know which will be the effects of these glazes. I always start with the smoke mallow. You can choose to either make one big stripe of colors, or you can make two smaller ones with a little black line in between. That's what I'm going to do with this one, but you can just choose how much lines you want to make. It of course depends on the size of your mug, or well, actually whatever you're glazing, because you can do this glazing technique also on planters or vases, so you can just experiment with this. For each color I use two layers, and I now will show you how I apply this. When I'm glazing the outside of the mug, I like to hold my hand on the inside with only my thumb on the outside, so it's easy to apply glaze on the whole outside. So what I do is just grab some glaze. Okay, so that was the first mug. Now I will be showing you a time lapse of the other two mugs. I won't be explaining how to glaze it, because you can just see it and it works the same as the first mug. So I hope you like it and keep on watching. And the last thing we need to do, which you shouldn't forget, is cleaning the bottom, because as you can see, there's still some glaze on the bottom which we need to get rid of. So what I use is this pad. I'm not sure what it's called and what it's for, but you could also just use a piece of carpet or a towel. But what I do is I just wet it a bit and then I use it to clean the bottom. What you do is just grab one of your mugs, make sure your hands are dry, otherwise the glaze will stick to your hand, and then you can just put it on the pad and just twist it around and push a little bit. And as you can see, the glaze gets off, so if there's still some glaze, you can do it again and just repeat this until you think your bottom is clean enough to go into the kiln. This was it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you liked it and it was helpful for some of you guys. If you liked it, please put a thumbs up. And if you're interested in more of my videos, which will follow, please subscribe to my channel and stay tuned. So I will see you in the next video and thank you for watching. Bye!